My name is Cameron McHale, the Director of Sales Engineering for Logic.io. And today I'm going to be walking you through Logic.io's matrix loader, or the ability for customers to import via CSV all of the fields, options, rules, and tables that they would require for a configuration. So starting out in my Salesforce CPQ quote, if I come in to add my new compact track loader, you're going to see that as of right now, I currently have no configuration in place for my track loader, as we can see by our error message showcased to us here. And this is because if I come into my configurable products that tie the Logic.io configurations to the Salesforce CPQ products and view the Logic.io administration, I can see that I currently have no fields and no rules associated to my compact track loader product. To account for this, I'm going to utilize the matrix loader by Logic.io. In the matrix loader, I have an option of different sample files available for upload, so I always have all of the templates I need in my hands. And by simply adding in all of my fields, options, and rules, I can upload this data directly into Logic.io and into my configuration. The only step that I have, once uploaded, is to associate all of the different fields that I uploaded to my particular product. This is because Logic.io utilizes the concept of global fields, so you can reuse fields across different products as you need. And once all of my fields are associated, all of the rules that are associated to those fields are automatically added as well. Now I can simply deploy, and in a few moments, I'll take you back through our quote to see our configuration. But first, let's walk through what I just uploaded. For my different fields, I have the ability to upload the field as well as the various options that are available for this field. For fields, you can have texts, booleans, numbers, as well as pick lists, as we're seeing on the screen here. I was also able to upload all of my rules as well. And you can see here, I have a number of rules available, and each rule is going to have a set of conditions and a set of actions that will be firing once all of those conditions are met. You can have multiple actions on one rule. It's not a one-to-one ratio. Now let's head back into our Salesforce CPQ, which I'm able to do directly from my Logic admin screen. And let's take a look at that configuration that we just uploaded. So utilizing my normal steps with Salesforce CPQ, as I come in to add my products, I will now be launched into the Logic configuration. Now what you see on my screen that was not here before is all of my different fields, all of the options associated, and as I begin to move through my configuration, you'll see all of my rules firing as well. So if I want to utilize model one in my first lane, I can now see that all of my default values were set based off of my selection, as well as all of my products are being added here on the right for my configuration and my quote. If I make updates, you'll see here at the bottom, some of my different offerings change as well. And then based off of my different selections, I can either have read only or be able to change my options. If I make a couple of new selections, you'll see that I also have uploaded different error messages and constraint rules as well. All of this was made possible by simply utilizing the matrix loader within Logic.io. And as I come back in to create my quote, I'll now be pulled from the Logic Configurator back into Salesforce CPQ without me as an end user ever noticing that I left. So please let us know if you have any questions and feel free to reach out to Logic.io for all of your configuration needs.